Good evening. Good evening, everyone. If you're there, just wave your hand. Thank you for tuning in this evening. I pray that thus far your week has been pleasant. I know it's the hump day, and I pray that God's shining face was with you all week thus far. Again, thank you for tuning in to First United Methodist Church Bible study. Again, I thank you for tuning in. We have a few prayer requests that I would like to lift up. I was trying to just wait a few more minutes and give people more time to chime in. If you're there, please wave your hand. Let me know you're there. Amen. Before we go into the prayer. Amen. We want to lift up the Rivers family. Miss Rivers was the oldest member here at First Church here in Elgin, and I believe she was 97. So we want to continue to pray for that family. Also for Sister Aveta Jenkins and her family, and Pastor Carter at Simpson as they on Saturday at 11 o'clock they would be doing our eulogy. Also, my Aunt Betsy, my wife Annie, want to lift her family up as we eulogize her on Saturday at 11 as well in San Antonio, Texas. Pray for me as I will have to be able to be blessed enough to do her eulogy. Also keep the Nesby family in prayer. Derek Nesby buried his wife on yesterday, and we want to keep that family lifted up as well. Also, continue to lift up our First Church, our praise team and our choir, and this Advent season that we find ourselves in. I pray that we take the time to really analyze where we are in our personal relationship with God through Jesus Christ and through the Holy Spirit. We'll be coming up on our third week of Advent. Last week, we lit the candle of peace. So I'll be dealing with peace today in Bible study. And I pray that something will be said or heard that you will help you along your journey today. Amen. Let us pray for those who have been lifted up. Dear Heavenly Father, we gave you the prayer list of those who are going through personal loss, Lord. We pray for their strength. I pray also, Father, for this church and our praise team and our choir in this Advent season that we found ourselves in, Lord, that we really examine who we are in Christ and our relationship with you, Father. I pray, Lord, that you will hide me behind that cross, that the words of my heart be pleasing up unto you. The words of my mouth be pleasing unto you, Lord, that I may be able to lead your people into a place of understanding and peace. In the name of Jesus, we pray. Well, good evening, everyone who's watching. We're dealing with peace. The Advent candle that we will lit on Sunday was the candle of peace. And if you catch what I'm teaching, Advent season, it was hope, then peace, and then Sunday will be joy. Those things are, we look for an emotion. Peace, it can be an emotional thing. Amen. Peace, as we think of it, can be the absence of trials of tribulation. can be absence of nothing going wrong in your life. Peace is the freedom from disturbance, as the dictionary describes it, a place of tranquility. It's emotional, and it's up and down. We have peace one day, and then we're on the valley the other. I'm offering you, because we look for peace in situations and in things. Like last week, we talked about hope. We find hope in people, places, or things, or situations. Again, the theme of my Advent teaching is that we don't find our hope or our peace in earthly things. Because things change daily. People change daily. Situations change daily. But the one thing that remains the same is God. And so our peace is predicated on our relationship with God. Peace is when I got to see both of my sisters-in-law, Sylvia and Vicky. Peace is something that the Holy Spirit gives us when he imparts into our heart, and knowing that no matter what circumstances I find myself in, I have the assurance of peace, not because of the situation, not because of people, but because who gives me my peace. My peace comes from God. John 14 and 27, the lesson today. Peace I leave with you, my peace I give you. I do not give to you as the world gives. Do not let your hearts be troubled, and do not be afraid. Christ is sharing with us in this season that we're in, and this is this Advent season that we celebrate as Methodists. It's preparing us for the birth of Jesus, and it's also a time for us to reflect on our relationship with God. Are we really in a relationship with God? Do we spend time with God? Do God know us? Do we hear our cry? Do we understand who we are because of a relationship we have? And so peace, and we talked about hope, doesn't come in invisible things. My peace and my joy and my hope comes from God. And it's in God. The one constant thing in our life that never changes is God. Again, people, things, situations, anything that we see in everyday life, it changes. And if we are basing our feelings on the world's situation or people's situation, then our emotions will go up and down. That's why sometimes we high and sometimes we low. Amen? But with Christ, in Christ, through the Holy Spirit working within us, we always will have peace, no matter the situation. Not saying that death and tribulations and fear and uncertainty and doubt is constantly at war in our minds. We always struggle with this, but Christ through the Holy Spirit helps us deal with those inner demons that we fight within ourselves, so that we can remain in that playing field of peace. When you lose someone, when you lose a loved one, when you're going through the valley moments, when you're hurting and uncertainty is all around you, and it looks as if that there is no answer, or you're emotional because you don't see a way out or don't see the fix. The thing is, when I'm in that relationship with God, I may feel all these things I just described to you, but when I can sit down and take a deep breath, I understand that I can have peace in the middle of the storm because of who's with me, whose love is consistent, who's never put no more than I can bear, who never leave nor forsake me. I can take a deep breath and have my peace, knowing that Christ is with me, that God is my comforter. He's my strength. He's my help in a time of trouble and need and want. And that's easier said than done. It takes a mindset and a relationship to know God, and how sometimes it seems as if your peace is never going to get there. You lost who you are because your mind keeps playing tricks with you. That's where the enemy attacks our thought process. But when we can come to ourselves, we know that Christ loves us and that Christ is a sustainer of our peace and our hope. It's found in God. Philippians 4:6-7 puts it this way. Do not be anxious about anything, but in every situation by prayer and petition, with thanksgiving, present your request to God. And watch this now. And the peace of God, which transcends all understanding, will guard your hearts and your minds in Jesus Christ. Hallelujah, saints. Huh? It's nothing better than that. To not to be anxious. And see, the world will make us anxious. And the world will make us have all these anxiety attacks and all these other things that are going on. But Christ is the peacemaker. I'm reminded in scripture in Matthew when the disciples were sent to the other side. And Jesus got down in the middle of the boat and went to sleep. He fell asleep. And then a big raging storm came. And the winds were overtaking the boat and water was coming on the boat. And the disciples ran down into the middle of the boat and to wake Jesus up. Jesus, do you not care that we perish? Jesus got up and went on the deck and just reached his hand and said, peace, be still. And the storm and the wind and the rain ceased to exist. And he turned to his disciples, the people who had been following him and know who he was, you know, because they couldn't understand why Jesus was sleeping in the middle of that storm. The key is that Jesus is with us in our storms. He's never left our side for the believer in Christ. The disciples cried out because they were worried. They were so overtaken by what they saw. They just knew death was coming their way. We get overwhelmed with situations and things in our life that we seem that's gripping us and causing us to be still and to waver in our faith and in our belief. The disciples were the same way that you are today. I don't care who we are. We have fallen in somewhere in our lives, in our children, relationship, that we feel like we've been overtaken. And we forget who's with us. The disciples forgot who was in the middle of the boat. They forgot who was riding with them. They forgot about the miracles that they saw him do. Took the 2 loaves and 5 fish and fed the 5,000. They forgot he's the same one to raise Lazarus from the dead. They forgot that he's the one that gave the sight to the blind. They forgot that he was the one that healed the leper. They forgot that he was the one who the paralyzed man was lowered to him, that he told him, pick up your mat and walk. We forget in a trial, in the times of adversity or a disruption in life, who we serve and the power that he has. We forget that he's in the inside of us. The temple of God dwells within us through the Holy Spirit. We forget who he is. And he just simply steps up and say, peace, be still. And the calmness came over the nature, the wind and the rain and the storms. So what makes you think he can't fix our stuff? The God who created, who can make the wind and the rain and the storms, the disciples became afraid. They said, what kind of man is this that he can speak and the wind and the rain obeys him? We forget the power of God. He is the peacemaker in our lives. He's the one that brings us the peace that sustains us, the peace that he leaves us the world cannot understand. Huh? Can't understand. I can remember being a little boy and crawling in my grandmother's arms as she sit on the porch and rocked in San Antonio, Texas. I have never felt so much peace. I felt protected. I felt sheltered. This is what God does for us. He's our protector. He gives us peace in the midst of adversity and confusion. See, it's not predicated on a situation. This peace that he's talking about is with you 24/7 through the Holy Spirit. You know, why we up and down so much is because our emotions are involved in it, and that we're not on a level playing field. Because Philippians 4:6 says, "Do not be anxious about anything, but in every situation by prayer and petition." When we learn to pray in every situation in our lives, we can be level. Amen? No matter what's going on, I got peace. People be walking around, you should have lost your mind. Why you have so much joy in your life? Why you not acting as the world will have you to act? It's not because I'm not hurting. It's not because I'm not sad. It's not because I haven't had any crying times. But it's because I know. I know him. I know him. He's the peace that I lean on. He's what I depend on. He's what I desire. He's what I want for my life. It's not the situation. It's not people. And it's not the death of loved ones that I look at. I hurt like everyone else hurt. But at the end of the day, I have peace. Because of Christ, I trust him. Do you trust him with your whole life? Do you love him with your whole mind, heart, and soul? This is for believers. I trust him. It doesn't mean that I don't get up every day and do something. I know that works, faith without works is dead, and works without faith is dead. So I got to get up and do something. But I still have peace. Hallelujah. In all situations, because of who God is, because of God, because of relationship with God. I can't emphasize this enough. This Advent season, please reflect on where you are with Christ. Reflect on your relationship. Look in the mirror and say, Lord, where am I at? Where are my shortcomings are? Strengthen me. Amen. I know me and I know my shortcomings, Lord. So help me to be better. I give my life, my heart, and my mind to you, God, so because you are my peacemaker. I love you, Lord. And so I know that storms will arise in my life. Heartaches are going to arise in my life. But I can stand because of you, God. Because of you. I'm praying for someone to get the strength that they need. It's because of God. Huh? It's only because of God. I want us to get this. You know, as a pastor, you know, you hear us talk like we got it together, or like we don't hurt, or like I don't have bad days, or I'm sad at times. You know, I hurt like anyone, but at the end of the day, I know God. I know God's going to make a way. And my peace and my hope and on Sunday on the joy calendar and my joy comes from God. Because everything else is temporary on this earth. Everything that you put your hope in and your joy in this earth, it's temporary. That's why you're up and down all over the place. But when your hope, your peace, and your joy is predicated on your relationship with God through the Holy Spirit, who strengthens you each day, amen, who makes you understand your relationship with God, knowing that, hey, he already told me trials and tribulations are going to come. But he said, be in good cheer. I have overcome the world. So whatever I have to face, I already know he already defeated it. So that gives me a remnant of peace. Does it make it easy to go through it? No. But it makes it, I have peace going through it because of who's already been there for me, who's already made the way for me, and it's God. Amen. The greater is he in me than he's in the world. That peace that surpasses all understanding. And Lord knows we need peace. I don't want to have to die to have peace. I can have peace right here on earth. He said, what you bind up in heaven, hey, what you bind up here on earth, and he bind up in heaven. So if I bind up the hatred and the bigotry and the uneasiness that we find here on this earth, God would help me go through this. And so I'm encouraging you tonight. Peace. You can have all the money in the world. You can be Elon Musk. But if you don't have peace, peace is, you can't purchase. There's no amount of money that can give you peace. Because the more money you have, the more ways you're trying to figure out to keep it. You don't have it, peace. Unless you have a relationship with God. Amen. Remember, do not be anxious about nothing, but be in prayer about everything. I don't know about you. That's my joy. And knowing that God is in control and I'm submitting myself to God. Amen. And in return, he gives me this peace. I don't know how to make it any more simple. Is that the relationship with God during this Advent season, you need to check it and see where you are. So that every day my peace is getting bigger and better in Christ. And believe me, I hurt just like you hurt. But God is bigger than my hurt. And the love of Christ is bigger than my pain. So guess what? I got peace in the storm, in the valley, because of God. Hallelujah. Amen. Again, I want to lift up the Townsend family. My nephew Darian, they fell a little short in the championship game on last week. But the good news is he's on the dean list and he will graduate with his master's. Hallelujah. There's always a silver lining with God. Amen. Again, I want to thank you, Ms. Debbie Sanford. I thank you for who you are and the leadership that you have in this church. So my friend Jan, I'm glad you're done with your surgeries and your eye surgeries, that you're back in one piece. Sylvia Hood, we pray things to continue to grow and get better for you. Who else I can see on there? Whoever is out there that I can't see, I pray that God is working in your life. And remember, there's only a couple weeks before Christmas, and I haven't done anything. Amen. So I'm going to be pushing in the last minute. But God knows them grandkids of mine, we get something. Amen. And my wife and our anniversary is on the 27th. So I got to do double deal with that. Amen. So keep me in your prayers. Keep our church. I love our church. And I tell everyone we love each other and we love our community. And that's what we're about, is loving each other in our community. I will end in a prayer. Gracious God, we thank you for this opportunity to come before your people. We love you, Lord. We know that you're working things out for the better, even when we don't understand it. We pray for that peace, Lord, that peace that comes not on people or situation, but the peace of knowing who you are in our life, the peace that the Holy Spirit imparts in us through our hearts, through that we feel every day. Because every day is not a good day for us personally, but every day with you is better than the day before. Scripture tells us that, and we say, thank you, Lord. And in the name of Jesus, we pray. I want to leave you with something that I found. It's number 6. Get this, number 6, verse 24 to 26. He said, as God was telling Moses how to teach Aaron how to greet the Israelites. The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face shine on you and be gracious to you. The Lord turn his face towards you and give you peace. Let me read that again. That is so soothing. The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face shine on you and be gracious to you. The Lord turn his face towards you and give you peace. Those are my closing remarks to you. God bless you. I love you, and there's nothing you can do about it. May God's face shine upon you until we meet again. Sunday's message, the joy that I have, the world didn't give it, and the world can't take it away. Hallelujah. Bye-bye.